Hi, this is Nathan, your neighborhood arcade and pinball talk guy. We're going to be reviewing Universe Retro today on Zakaria and Steam. Please look for our review underneath the description of our YouTube video, as well as like and follow us on our social media formats, Arcade and Pinball Talk under Facebook groups, Instagram, Twitter, as well as YouTube. Click that red subscribe button. If you like arcade, if you like virtual pinball, if you like mechanical pinball, hell, we love it all. We talk pinball in all of its formats. In every version possible. So if you like pinball as much as we do, join our family, click that red subscribe button down below, and let's keep the conversations going. Anyway, let's get this review underway, shall we? This is definitely I'm actually liking this table so far. It's actually got a kind of a standardized setup, older EM, solid state kind of table, and it's a quick player too. It's a banger and clanger. All you're hearing, bang, bang, bang. No soundtrack, but other than that, so far, so good. Smaller flippers. That can be a pro and a con. Not for Primus. I actually like that table. Some people would disagree with me. But anyway, so far, so good. Artwork is there. Flow is working, from what I can tell. Flipper gap is wide, but then you also have a stop peg to the middle. Some people call them magic posts. It's not like it's rising or anything. Let's just call it a peg and it stops things. You have slings to the left and the right. You also have some rollover outlanes to the left and the right. You have some lanes to the left and the right middle, which are 100 points when lit. You have some kickouts to the middle. There's three. Circle of pop bumpers. Lots of lanes with rollovers to the left all the way around to the top. And that's it. Pretty much sums it up. Simple table. Still difficult. I would say the level of difficulty here is high moderate. It's not a low high or a very high difficulty. I think the flippers being in its natural setup is very beneficial to make this game replayable over the long run, especially for newer people getting into pinball. But this is one of those games where, you know, you can really work on your skill shot with this one. You do have the ability to cradle the ball, see, just like that. And so you can cradle that ball and then try to, like, maybe backhand it. Not a whole lot of force on it. That's one thing about these older tables. They don't really pop that flipper too much. So if you try to backhand it, you don't really get a whole lot of pop off of that, as you just saw. So never mind, I take that back. Some of the newer tables, you can backhand and go to the right or the left, kind of like shooting and pull, hitting the static on a pull ball and having the ball go completely sideways. But anyway, great looking table. I like the colors. I'm liking the banging and the clanging. I feel like I'm in a casino. And so far, it's got a smooth play to it. Ball speed's actually fast. It's not like slowed down or monotonously slow, which some of these tables can be, but also you got to have faith in that stop peg, as you just saw. I mean, I knew it was going to go in that area, but I just had faith in it, let it ride, and it saved my ball for me. So not too bad so far. Replayability on this is there. Fun factor is absolutely there. I think this is a great table. So, you know, Universe, definitely a must play on retro. I will say that first and foremost here. It's got a good layout. The flow to the center is good, and it keeps the ball up there. See that it goes into the kick out again. So it just has what you need, that table does. Universe on Retro Zakaria. Check it out. Download it. You're going to love that table. Anyway, look for the metrics underneath our description of our video, and that's where you'll find our review. Other than that, click that red subscribe button, and we look forward to our next video with you guys. Thank you again for your time today.